We'll be discussing about the anatomy of pons. Pons, P-O-N-S. So what do you understand by this word, pons? If somebody asks you, till now you have already been knowing about the neuroanatomy, so can anybody tell me about the pons? Second and third point, she told about the location and the where it is present. It is present between the midbrain and the medulla. And if we see in the cranial fossa, it is lying in the posterior cranial fossa, that too on the clivus. और किस तरह के fibers pass करते हैं pons से? किसी को connect करता है pons? Longitudinal and transverse fibers होते हैं pons में. Very good. हाँ बोलो. Cerebellum से connect करता है through cerebellar peduncles. तो एक जनरल आइडिया तुम लोगों को है पॉन्स कहाँ पे है, किसका पार्ट है. तो पॉन्स का लिटरल मीनिंग क्या होता है? ब्रिज. तो व्हाई इट इज बीइंग सेड ब्रिज? इट्स बिकॉज इट इज कनेक्शन का काम करता है किसके बीच में. सो इट इज अ ब्रिज, दैट मीन्स इट इज कनेक्टिंग समथिंग. सो इट इज कनेक्टिंग द सेरिबेलम एंड इट इज कनेक्टिंग द हायर सेंटर्स ऑफ द ब्रेन. Does it connect the midbrain and medulla? Yes. So developmentally it is the part of the hindbrain and that too it is developing from the metencephalon. So metencephalon is the part of the which division? Teen parts hote hain. Kiska part hai? Metencephalon is the part of the rhomban cephalon. You have three divisions of the brain. Ye picture sabko clear hai, brain vesicles form hote hain. Frozen cephalon, that is the fourth brain. Then you have mesencephalon, midbrain, and the rhomban cephalon, hindbrain. So we are discussing the rhomban cephalon, in which they have division of metencephalon and myelencephalon. Metencephalon develops into the pons and the cerebellum. Myelencephalon will develop into the medulla. So this is the region of the pons which is lying between the midbrain and the medulla and ventral to the cerebellum. Now what are the functions of the pons? It is also a relay station. It is relaying the fibers from the cerebral cortex to the cerebellum and it is also giving the fibers from one cerebellum to the other cerebellum. Then it regulates the breathing. So it is the breathing center, that is a respiratory center is located in the pons. And when you see the fiber formation, that is the white matter formation in the pons, you will see the reticular formation which is involved in the sleep and arousal pathways. Now this you have already told me that it is the middle part of the brainstem. It is bridging the midbrain, hindbrain. It is the bridge between the two cerebellar hemispheres. And the last point is it is the floor of the fourth ventricle. So when you see that, if you remove the pons, then you will see the fourth ventricle. So it is forming the floor of the fourth ventricle. This is the sagittal section of the brain where we can see the midbrain. This is the extent of the pons. This hole is the pons and this is the medulla. So behind this, this will be the ventral surface. Any confusion in this, that this is the ventral surface and this is the dorsal surface? Kisi ko koi confusion hai is point mein? Nahi hai. So dorsal surface is forming the floor of the fourth ventricle. This cavity is the fourth ventricle, right? This is the roof of the fourth ventricle, this is the floor of the fourth ventricle and this is the cavity. So floor of the fourth ventricle is formed by the dorsal surface of the pons. This is the position of the pons. This section has been taken along with the head and neck section. So you have all skull intact, facial bones, muscles, they are intact. So what we can see here is the part of the posterior cranial fossa. This portion is called as the clivus. Clivus is formed by which parts of the bones? Sphenoid and the occipital. The basi sphenoid and basi occipital, they join to form the slope-like structure which is called as the clivus. So on this clivus is resting the brain stem. Now if you see the pons, if you take out this pons, you have two surfaces and two borders. Two borders which are merged between the midbrain and the medulla and two surfaces. One you can see on the inferior side of the brain, other you cannot see, that is embedded. So if this is the inferior view of the brain where we can see the ventral surface of the pons. So this is the ventral surface of the pons. This boundary, this is the superior border. Above this, these are the cerebral peduncles, which are the part of the midbrain. So this is the superior border, and this one is the inferior border. So ventral surface has got the basilar sulcus. In this picture, you can see in front of the pons one artery is going. This artery is basilar artery, which is formed by the joining of the two vertebral arteries. So two vertebral arteries joining to form basilar. So that basilar artery, it is running on the surface of the pons. So this is the sulcus, which is called as the basilar sulcus. So artery has been removed from here, and it has caused the depression. This is called as basilar sulcus. Then you can see middle cerebellar peduncles here. So cerebellar peduncles kya hote hain? Peduncles are the fibers which are connecting the cerebellum. So here you can see the middle cerebellar peduncles which are connecting it to the cerebellum. Then you can see trigeminal nerve. You all know that 5th cranial nerve is emerging from the pons. 6th, 7th and 8th, they are emerging from the junction between the pons and the medulla. So the 5th cranial nerve will be present over the pons. So this is the trigeminal nerve. Then you can find the transverse ridges. On the gross anatomy only, you can see these features, that is basilar sulcus, cerebellar peduncle, trigeminal nerve, transverse ridges, bulbopontine sulcus, CP angle, that is cerebellar pontine angle. So transverse ridges, these are the transverse ridges formed by the transverse fibers running over the pons. Then what is bulbopontine sulcus?